Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends. In this video, we will see the numericals based on frequency reuse. Following is the question given for the frequency reuse. The question is as follows. If a total of 33 MHz of bandwidth is allocated to a particular FDD cellular telephone system, now we'll see the numerical on frequency reuse. Following is the question given. If a total of 33 MHz of a bandwidth is allocated to a particular FDD cellular telephone system, which uses two 25 kHz of simplex channels to provide full duplex voice and control channels, compute the number of channels available per cell if the system uses A. 4-cell reuse, B. 7-cell reuse, and C. 12-cell reuse. If 1 MHz of the allocated spectrum is dedicated to control channels, determine an equitable distribution of control channels and voice channels in each cell for each of the three systems. We'll see how to solve this numerical. Total bandwidth is given as 33 MHz. It is said that 1 MHz is used for control channels only. Hence, for voice channel, we are now left with only 32 MHz. One simplex channel is of 25 kHz. Because we require a duplex communication, then we require two channels. So, one pair of duplex communication system is going to require 50 kHz. Now we'll see the total number of channels that are available in every system. First, we'll see the total voice channels available. The total voice band is given to us as 32 MHz. We will divide one duplex channel bandwidth, which is 50 kHz, and then find out how many duplex channels are available. Total 640 channels are available. Now we'll see in 4-channel reuse how the frequency distribution takes place. Now we'll see the number of channels that are required in 4-cell reuse. For 4-cell reuse, what we do is we divide the total number of channels into 4 cells. The answer here is 160 voice channels. Similarly, we will see for 7-cell reuse and 12-cell reuse. For 7-cell reuse, we divide the total number of channels equally into 7. But we see here the answer is 91.4. We all know that the channels cannot be in decimal number of points. That is why what we do is, for some cells we give more channels and for some cells we give less channels. So the distribution here is, for 4 cells we will give 91 channels and for next 3 cells we will give 92 channels, which together will form 640 channels. Next we go for 12-cell reuse. We divide the total number of channels, that is 640, into 12. The answer here is 53.33. But we again know that decimal cannot be the answer for number of channels. Next, we go for 12-cell reuse. In 12-cell reuse, we divide the total number of channels, that is 640, equally into 12. The answer that we get here is 53.33. But we all know that channels cannot be decimal number of points. Hence, to some cells, we give more channels and to the other ones, we give less channels. So the distribution is as follows. So for 8 cells here, we will give 53 channels and the remaining 4 cells, we will give 54 channels. Now if we combine, the total we get is 640 channels. Next, we will see how the control channels are distributed. Since 1 MHz is given for control channels, first we will find out how many control channels are possible. Now we'll see control channel distribution. Since we know 1 MHz is given for control channels, we will first find out how many actual duplex channels can be taken out from that 1 MHz. The bandwidth for one duplex channel is 50 kilohertz. So the total number of control channels is nothing but 1 MHz divided by 50 kilohertz. The answer here is 20 channels. We have 20 control channels which can be distributed. Now we'll see in 4-cell reuse, 7-cell reuse and 12-cell reuse, how we can distribute these control channels. So here, in 4-cell reuse, what we can do is, 20 channels are divided by 4. The answer here is 5 channels per cell. But remember, every cell, one control channel is enough because control channels are only used for setup purposes. Now we will see in 7-cell reuse. For 7-cell reuse, the answer that we get is 2.857. We know that the channels cannot be decimal number of points, hence the distribution is as follows. For one cell, we give 2 channels and for the remaining 6 cells, we will give 3 channels, which in total will give us 21 control channels. But we again remember that control channels are only one sufficient. For 12-cell reuse, we divide the total number of control channels by 12. The answer that we get here is 1.66. So again, the distribution is as follows. Four cells will get one control channel and the remaining 8 cells will get 2 control channels, which in total give us 20 control channels. So this is how the distribution of voice channels and control channels is been done. Here what we have done is, we have individually divided the channels into voice and control. Thank you so much for watching this video. Stay tuned to Ikeeda and subscribe to Ikeeda.